Yeah, I'm all right. I'm okay.
And do a couple tests for me, okay? I know you've been having a couple drinks tonight, but I gotta make sure you're not above the legal limit, okay? Can you tell me what this object is? It's a pen. See the tip of the pen, top of it? I want you to follow it with your eyes only.
Your head still.
Okay, this is just an alka sensor, okay? It's just gonna tell me if you've been drinking, positive or negative. Take a deep breath, blow constant, don't try to spit in it or anything else, alright? Go ahead and do that. Okay, do me a favor, turn around for me. Your hands behind your back. You're under arrest while driving while intoxicated, okay? You know the legal limit in New York State? Lewis? You know the legal limit in New York State? Okay, you're under 21. There's zero tolerance, okay? Go back to my vehicle.
Side of the vehicle. Patient is unconscious, unresponsive. Patient has a suspected skull fracture. There are no other visible injuries.
Let's get him moved over. One, two, three.
I found absolutely nothing except for the obvious head injury.
Get his shirt off, please. We need the rest of his clothes off so I can see what we're doing. What was his last blood pressure? Can we get a
blood pressure right now, 153 over 96.
Activate the operating room, tell them that we have a trauma with active bleeding in the abdomen, positive FAS. Are you with us? Hello? Still unresponsive, let's intubate him please before we get him to the OR.
We're seeing the blood up.
And a 7.5. Can I get 20 of Atomidate, please? And we'll get 100 of Sox. We're just going to push the Atomidate first and see if we have any response, okay? I don't know how much you know about what's going on. He was found on the scene by EMS, unresponsive. He had some pretty significant head injuries. He's in the operating room, and when he left the emergency department, he was stable. But at this point, I don't have any further information. He's undergoing surgery. Okay? Thank you.
Okay, Lewis, can you see this first cell for me? We're gonna go in there, okay? Go ahead and have a seat right on the bench. Okay, Lewis, what we're gonna do, like I told you, you were under arrest for driving while intoxicated, okay? We're actually gonna pull you out. We're gonna have you submit to a breath test, okay? All right, go ahead and stand up for me. Walk out this way. You're gonna see a green box up here in front of you. I want you to put both feet inside of it. Okay, what I want you to do is take a big inhale. Okay, it's gonna be a long, consistent breath. Go ahead and blow. Good. Okay, Lewis, do you know the legal limit in New York State? What is it? 0.08. Okay, you are a 1.6. 0.16. You are double the legal limit right now, okay? What we're gonna do, we're gonna have another seat back in our cell. We'll process you and do some more paperwork, all right? Mr. Avellino, are you aware of what actually happened tonight? Okay. Are you aware that two people are deceased at this time? Okay. At this point, I have several charges here I'm going to read to you out loud. Let me know if you have any questions. First charge is an E felony for vehicular assault in the second degree, a D felony of vehicular manslaughter in the second degree, a B felony of aggravated vehicular homicide, and another D felony of vehicular manslaughter in the second degree. All these will be read to you in court in front of a judge later in this proceeding. At this time, we are going to remove you. I do have to fingerprint you, take your photograph, and finish the booking process. Stand straight up, straight ahead. Very good. Turn around for me. I'm going to take the handcuffs off. I'm going to take the left one off and place it on top of your head, okay? We're going to start with your right hand. Good. Okay, what you're going to do, I'm going to let you back in here. There is some pumice soap on the wall. It'll take the ink right off of your hands if you want to go ahead and in there. All right, we're going to put the handcuffs on you. We are going to go before a judge, so you have to stay behind your back, okay? Just so you are aware, Lewis, I did contact your parents. They're out in the hall. They will be present during your arraignment in front of the judge, okay? Now I don't understand.
All right, we got a 16-man with ejected to MVC, unresponsive heart, terrified with him. Do not have an airway current. He was good compliance with no feeling, but that's a decrease
to the I'll have to stick to you all.
We've got some significant
facial abrasions. It's a good conversation.
Sir, can you open your eyes for me? Open your eyes for me. So, has he moved at all for you?
I am a fire escape.
Yes. Please,
what
your count?
Okay.
One, two, three.
Okay, he's got very diminished lung sounds throughout. What's his last blood pressure?
Last blood pressure was over 40. His last pulse is 30 and declining steadily.
Can we get his pants off, please? I don't have any regular pulses. Was he ever responsive at any time?
No responsible.
Okay, what do we have for access?
We have 2 16s bilaterally, the ACs.
Okay, what has he had so far?
Just flu at this point.
Okay, great.
I see the seasons change.
Fast, it's positive.
All the young faces come and replace the dying ones. Sit out on Lexington.
I need 2 chest trays set up, please, with Hemovax. I'm going to do bilateral chest juice on him.
We begin to stop and
we have a chest tube set up right over here.
Good blood return on this side. Please, somebody check the femoral pulse. Keep your finger on the femoral pulse and let me know if you have a femoral pulse, please. How's he bagging?
Bagging easy.
We're gonna do another pulse check, okay? I wanna get a sugar and some ice now. Reassess lung sounds.
Pick yourself up and change.
still have good, so if everybody's in agreement, we're going to pronounce the time of death is 1548.
I watched the dreamers find their legs, and I seen the ones that come get reduced to bones and rags. Cause I am a fire escape, the spine is made of iron.
My surprise rips up when you see, okay? So I just need you to verify that this is Robert.
Save yourself, save yourself. Save yourself, save yourself.
Evelino, so it makes you 18 years of age, correct?
Yes, sir.
And where? Okay, do you attend school?
Yes, sir.
Where do you attend school?
Fayetteville-Manlius High
School. All right, your first charge is that on April 16th, 2014, at 82 North 22nd, be advised on the vehicle and traffic charges that plead guilty to the charges equivalent to a conviction after trial. If you are convicted, not only will you be liable to a penalty, but in addition, your license or registration, if any, are subject to suspension and revocation as prescribed by law. Do you understand all those charges?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Anything else, Counselor?
No, Judge.
Anything else?
Nothing.
Okay. I'll be back here in 1 month. This is the case of the people of the state of New York versus Louis Avellino. I know Mr. Avellino is out on bail. Is that correct, Mr. Gorgoni?
Yes, Judge.
Mr. Avellino, do you understand the charges that they're going to ask you to plead guilty to?
Yes, Judge.
And you recall them. One is a B felony, aggravated vehicular homicide. And that states that you did, while you were intoxicated and with a blood alcohol content of 0.14%, that you did strike him out of a motor vehicle and kill one Robert Mentz and one Hannah Krause at that time. You understand that? You're admitting to that. Is that correct? Now the issue, it's my understanding that you both want to make some arguments here as to what the sentence would be. Mr. Bednarski, why don't you go first?
Judge, as you know, the tragedy caused by this young man's irresponsibility is immeasurable. Two people are dead. Someday, no matter what you sentence Mr. Avellino to today, he will walk free on the streets. The two people who are killed, they will never walk again. They will never graduate high school. They will never graduate college. They'll never grow up, live a life, breathe the air that Mr. Avellino will one day and continue to breathe.
Mr. Avellino, I've read the pre-sentence report here. You know, the sad thing is you are an exemplary young man, except for this instance. There's nothing else in there that I could find that shows that you have any propensity to do, you know, to break the law, to do things that are wrong. I would bet that 99% of the time, if you stopped before you did something and you thought about it, you probably would do the right choice. We all make mistakes, but most of the time you'd make the right choice. If you'd stopped before you started drinking and thought, I'm going to drive a vehicle, you probably would have made the right choice. You probably wouldn't have done this. But the problem is that you didn't. You didn't think. You just did these things. And because of your actions, there are two other people that are now dead. And that's something that, that you have to pay for. And hopefully it will become a lesson to you in the future, and that you will take this experience and try and turn it around and make something good out of it. That being said, I feel that a sentence here of 3 years to 8 years in prison is an appropriate sentence.
Hannah thinks of the person not in the limelight. Still
falling. Hannah has so many interests that you can't count them all. Breathless and all again. Hannah's always had a passion like that. And she'll see a problem and she'll want to do something about it and she'll act on it. So that's one of the things I remember.
It was you, breathless and torn. I could feel my eyes turning into dust and to strangers turning into dust. Turning into dust.
I keep telling Hannah she's going to change the world. It doesn't really matter what she studies, just who she is and what she comes up with and how she brings others along in her dreams and her passions is going to take her places.
Just her free spirit, her long hair, bright blue eyes, and just truly a happy girl. An angel.